This video is going to be about solving 3x3 systems of equations. And we're going to do this by the method of elimination. It's the same kind of elimination that you use with 2x2 systems of equations. So let's look at an example. Here we've got three equations, and I've numbered them 1, 2, and 3. The first equation is 2x minus 3y plus 2z equals 9. The second equation is 2x plus 3y minus z equals negative 3. And the third equation is 3x minus 2y plus z equals 10. And to start out, what I want to do is eliminate one of the variables so that I end up with two equations with two unknowns. So looking at these, I realize I've got this second equation with a negative z and the third equation with a positive z. So if I added those two equations together, the z's would cancel, and I just have x's and y's. So let's do that. I'm going to call that equation number 4. And equation number 4 is going to be number 2 plus number 3. So adding those together, I have 2x plus 3x is 5x. And 3y minus 2y is y. The negative z and positive z are going to cancel. And then I have negative 3 plus 10, which is 7. Now I've got to make another equation with just x and y. And looking at my first three equations, I realize if I take the second equation, which has a negative z in it, and multiply it by 2, that will give me a negative 2z. And then I could add it to the first equation, which has a positive 2z, and I would cancel my z's out. So I want to create equation number 5. And equation number 5 is going to be 2 times equation number 2 plus equation number 1. So let's do that over here. Equation number 2, 2x plus 3y minus z equals negative 3. And I want to multiply that. I'm going to multiply everything in this by 2. So I'll get 4x plus 6y minus 2z equals negative 6. And then I want to add equation number 1 to it. Well, equation number 1 was 2x minus 3y plus 2z, and that equaled 9. So adding those two together, 4x plus 2x is 6x. 6y minus 3y is 3y. The negative 2z and positive 2z are going to cancel. And negative 6 plus 9 is 3. So that's my equation number 5. I'll copy that over to here. 6x plus 3y equals 3. And I'm going to erase the work I've done over here just to make some more room. If you were doing this, probably the safest thing to do would be to do your extra work either on the side of the page or an additional piece of paper. That way you could refer back to it if you needed to. Okay, so I've got two equations with two unknowns. 5x plus y equals z equals 7, I'm sorry. And 6x plus 3y equals 3. And now what I've got to do is eliminate one of the variables again. And it looks like the easy one to eliminate would be the y. Since I have a y in equation number 4, I can multiply that by negative 3. I'll then have a negative 3y, add it to equation number 5, which has a positive 3y, and that will get rid of my y's. Okay, so I want equation number 4, which was, actually, let me write this down. I want to make equation number 6, which is going to be negative 3 times equation number 4 plus equation number 5. So equation number 4 is 5x plus y equals 7. I'm going to multiply that by negative 3. So negative 3 times 5x is negative 15x. Negative 3 times y is negative 3y. Negative 3 times 7 is negative 21. And I'm adding that to equation number 5, which is 6x plus 3y equals 3. So, adding those together, negative 15x plus 6 is negative 9x. Negative 3y plus 3y, those two will cancel. And negative 21 minus 3 is negative 18. And now all I have to do is divide by negative 9 on both sides, and I end up with x equals 2. So equation number 6, x equals 2, is actually one of my answers. It's one of the solutions to my problem. From here on out, everything gets very, very easy. All I have to do is take this x equals 2 and substitute it into either one of these equations with two variables, with an x and a y. So I'm going to pick the 5x plus y equals 7. I could have picked the other one, it doesn't really matter. So instead of 5x plus y equals 7, I'm going to have 5 times 2 plus y equals 7. 5 times 2 is 10, plus y equals 7. Subtracting 10 from both sides, I end up with y equals negative 3. So I've now got a second solution, y equals negative 3. Makes more room again. Now that I've got x and y, all I have to do is go back into one of my original three equations, the ones with three unknowns, and plug in the values of x and y and find out what z is. So I guess I'll take the first equation. So now I've got 2x minus 3y plus 2z equals 9. Instead of the x, I'm going to put in 2. So that's 2 times 2. Minus 3 times negative 3 plus 2z equals 9. Well, 2 times 2 is 4. Negative 3 times negative 3 is positive 9. Plus 2z equals 9. 4 and 9 is 13. So 13 plus 2z equals 9. I'll subtract 13 from both sides. I'm going to get 2z equals negative 4. So dividing by 2, I end up with z equals negative 2. So that's my third answer, z equals negative 2. So there's my solution. If I want to check this the same way I check 2 by 2 systems, I'll take each of these, I'll take the x equals 2, y equals negative 3, and z equals negative 2, and plug those values into each of my original three equations and make sure they balance. So let me just take a second and review what I've done. I started out with these three equations, the original three. Then what I've got to do is create two equations with two unknowns, basically by adding either the original equations together, as I did with equations 2 and 3, or adding some multiples of the equations together, as I did when I multiplied equation 2 times 2, so that I end up canceling out one of the variables. In this case, I canceled out my z's. I then ended up with two equations with two unknowns. This is the stuff you've been doing for a while now. I have to get down to one unknown. So what I do is I find some way of multiplying one of the equations so that I get the same coefficient in both equations, but one positive and one negative. That's how I got a negative 3y over here when I multiplied this whole equation by negative 3. Adding the two equations together, I end up with the identity of one of my variables, x equals 2. From there on, all I do is work my way back through the equations. I took that x equals 2 and plugged it into one of the two variable equations. I used the 5x plus y equals 7. I could have used the other one. That then gives me the identity of a second variable. After that, I do that same process again, plugging in the x and the y this time into one of my original equations, and that lets me know what the last variable is. Okay, so there's a lot of steps, a lot of places where you have to be careful, but basically there's nothing new here. This is just solving systems of equations by elimination. Get plenty of practice with this, and you should be fine. That's about it for now. Take care, and I'll see you next time.